You guys, this is my favorite Clash song. I know I've already talked about it, but I just thought I'd play it for you one more time because it just makes regular ass sexual intercourse really lame. And I think I can count on one hand the amount of times that I've done that, and it was a really magical, beautiful, heartwarming experience. Okay? That's what it should be. Sex should be raunchy and nasty and disgusting, like all this stuff has been made out to be. That's why the act can create life. You Western men, you're free with your seed. It's true. It's true. It's very, very true. Everything this song talks about. He's saying that the whole reason why birth control exists is because people are irresponsible and stupid and totally nihilistic about sexual intercourse. Okay? This is from a leftist communist punk band. Okay? So, I noticed a lot of punk bands are like really, really against, you know, just casual sex. Like the Specials have a song about that too. You know, the Ramones are pretty conservative. I think that punk is reactionary. And it doesn't surprise me that, like, so many people that are like, I don't want to typecast everybody, but I feel like, you know, people that would be like Christian conservatives or whatever, they probably wouldn't be in a band like this, you know? They wouldn't be into like anti-establishment. So I feel like the reason why people aren't so fucking docile and lame is because they're so okay with establishment. And it's the best part of the song. It's just amazing. This is the bass line. Like I said, you just wish you could have sex as good as this song. Fighter, y'all. Please love me. Don't hate me. Don't hate me. It's not because I need your seal of approval. Fuck that. I just would much rather us have a beautiful relationship than, you know, being ugly. I mean, I'm not going to engage in that. I don't want to. When I was younger, I'd have no problem in that. For however long, I could just rationalize that. See, I have too much self-awareness to rationalize being a shithead. You know, and I mean, I guess that's why I do this channel, so that I'm not a shithead in the real time. Because I'm not. I'm not a mean person. It's really hard for me to be mean, but I'm still honest, and that pisses people off. You know, I'm really, really honest, and I have boundaries, and I don't let people step all over. Oh, that was a little pug. We just saw a little pug. Just to let you know, this is one of my favorite kinds of dogs. I know they're stupid as fuck, but I feel for them. I empathize because they were literally bred to have a fucking breathing problem. You have any idea how fucked up that is? You want to complain about, like, pit bulls. They're literally bred to be vicious dogs that attack other dogs. Well, not dogs, specifically bulls. That's the name. But now they attack everything because they live in Western countries. I feel like the West has fucked it up because they didn't act this way originally. In Europe, they didn't act this way, so. But they have definitely been attacking all over the world, though. So I know it's not just a Western thing, because I look this shit up. Because I, you know, I just want to blame the West for every problem, but no, they're doing that shit in Africa, too. They're actually trying to ban pit bulls in South Africa because of the dog attacks. So when people are like, oh, that's not true. Have you ever seen a picture of a person that's been decapitated or had their fucking limbs chewed off or their fucking face gnawed to the point of no return? Like, no, that's something you can't deny once you see it, okay? I'm not saying that every pit is going to attack like that, and I'm not saying that they want to do that. Because I feel like it's just a lot of things that contribute. And they love to talk about the jabs, you know, whenever they involve kids, humans. They don't talk about them in regards to animals, all the problems they cause for animals, and they're literally injecting animals with rabies. What do you think that's going to do to a pit bull? Oh my god. Okay, I don't want to focus on the license plate. I just want you to see. We're literally listening to the Clash, y'all. We're literally listening to the Clash. I wish I could like speed up next to them and like play the Clash really loud, but I don't think that they would notice. I'm pretty sure their windows are up too. But that's exciting. There are more of us out there that know about bands as good as this. But a lot of people that I would side with politically would never listen to a band like this because they wouldn't vibe with the politics of it, you know? I mean, I think materialism is mainly why they hate capitalism. And everybody should hate materialism because materialism is the enemy of God, okay? It is. And why do you think all my shit's falling apart? It's like, yeah, maybe I don't take care of it. I know that. I'm a very flawed person that throws my shit around, okay? But like, I just hate how everybody's so obsessed with their stuff and they don't care about real experiences, man. They don't want to have real conversations with real people. They'd rather just do this fucking one up, I'm better than you are online. Like, honey, the reason I don't social network is because I don't want to engage in that shit. What are you doing? What are you doing, Clash fan? Come on now. We got to have better driving than that. They don't know where they are. They're going left. They're going left. Watch. There they go. No, this is hard to figure out. Like, this neighborhood right here. This neighborhood has, like, 5 different sections to it. So they probably didn't know which neighborhood they were in. That was the one where they were trying to go. But yeah. Dude, this sky is so beautiful tonight. Oh my goodness. I don't remember what I was talking about. per usual. That's annoying too, by the way. If you get annoyed with that, you have no idea how annoying it is for me, okay? Because I'll be watching my videos because we critique all of the videos. So for anybody that wants to say I don't have self-awareness, go fuck yourself. Because there's literally no way that I couldn't have self-awareness because I watch all of these videos and critique them. And there's a lot of shit that I say that I don't agree with. And I will put that in the description of the video and say, Amy, you fool. Or I'll be like, damn, you're a bitch, or, you know. I criticize myself. But yeah, it is, like, my world. Because I'm a fucking vlogger. That's what vlogs are. You don't vlog about other people's shit. That's not what a vlog is. Well, maybe it is. What if it is? I just don't know. I'm fucking ignorant. You better fucking school me.